Good evening. This side, Rahul Magan here is a Group Chief Executive Officer, Treasury Consulting, and also a second year law student. Today, deliberations is hybrid, which is as a hedge fund manager and also as a law student. Ladies and gentlemen, as you wisely aware, that I spare most of my time after doing my business in terms of reading magazines, newspapers, books, and all these things. When I try to gather as maximum as possible information from the public sources. I'm really fortunate that I'm associated with multiple magazines. Like one of them is definitely the Forbes India, reading two business newspapers in a day and finding a lot of concrete information, which is very difficult to find nowadays. Often I found out two things in the public domain. One is that a relevant XYZ investor is cutting the valuation of XYZ startup. Now, these news, unfortunately, is getting very often, and thanks to a concept which is known as funding winter. Technically speaking, funding winter means that the availability of funding to the startups is dying. And nowadays, there is another thing which is coming up in the public. And when I'm making this video, let me reconfirm that I'm making this video country agnostic, which means I'm not talking about any country. It is country agnostic, which means as a concept. The news which is coming is the convertibles, which is also led to a significant decision, which is called dilution. Now, to make my video more meaningful, let me go with the same example which I am taking in my most of the videos, and I once again repeat that God forbid if that name exists and the story which I am making is actually a real story, then it's purely a coincidence. Purely a coincidence. Suppose there is a company called Company ABC, and that company ABC is selling FMCG products across India or Singapore, US, UK, any country you choose, your favorite country, any country. And suppose this company, which is Company ABC, which is selling the FMCG product, they willingly or unwillingly selling at a negative contribution. Now, if you are a cost accountant, you would have understood the word contribution. But if you are not a cost accountant, then let me tell you, contribution means selling price minus variable cost. Any organization of the globe is having only two types of cost, either as a fixed cost or a variable cost. And cost accounting is having a wonderful tool to measure it, which is called contribution, which is means selling price minus variable cost. Now, contribution technically means that suppose you are selling that FMCG product. So, let me take a simple example. This company is selling pizza. Now, that pizza which you are selling, suppose you are selling $10, assuming, and this is your selling price, and unfortunately, the cost is coming $15, which means you are losing 50% of your selling price to every pizza you are selling. Across the globe, we have many cases where XYZ companies are reporting losses on a continuous basis. Now, this is one thing, but when it comes to accounting, every year, either you report profit or you report losses. They fall into a territory which is called negative retained earnings or equity. If you are making profit, then it will add to your equity, which is called reserves and surplus. And please take a note that net worth is a very, very well-known concept across the globe. When you value any company, whether it is a startup or it's a very big company, then the first source of valuation that comes into the picture is the net worth. The most often understood formula of net worth is equity plus reserves and surplus. I completely agree and appreciate that worldwide we have diversified formulas of net worth. Henceforth, I am also a believer of the thought process that one should not stick to this formula. Rather, if there is a viable alternate which is available, we should take that as well. Having said that, suppose the company which we're taking as an example, company ABC, who is selling FMCG products. Now, this company is incorporated in 2012, assuming, and today is 2023, which is precisely 11 years. In the last 11 years, this company is reporting losses after losses on a year-on-year basis, which means the losses which you are reporting, maybe media hide these losses, but these losses will end up in your balance sheet, which is called negative retained earnings. Like I said, the most often definition of a net worth is equities plus reserves and surplus, which practically means that your net worth is negative. Now, when startups form, generally speaking, startups get funding either via equity route or debt route. That completely depends how startup pitch their business model to the investors. Nowadays, we are quite lucky that the market is pretty wide. We are having sovereign wealth funds, private equity firms, venture capitalist firms, alternate investment funds. We have special situation funds. We have many kind of fund vehicles who are very much available in the public. You can contact them, email them, and if they feel that your resolution is viable, they will fund you. Of course, the terms and conditions to be determined by the term sheet. That term sheet to be in agreement between both the parties, and here comes the law. Ladies and gentlemen, technically speaking, I disagree with the term called term sheet because I believe that the better word is the framework agreement. There is a reason to it. But yes, maybe in the initial stages, you can title this as a term sheet, but the right meaning or the right word to use is called framework agreement. Henceforth, this is a very, very important founding stone. When these fund vehicles fund you, then they ask the company to give some collateral. Now, as a startup, you don't have any collateral. That's the reason you are raising the funding, because if you are having collateral, then what is the reason of having funding? Then what you do as a company, as an organization, you issue convertibles. Ladies and gentlemen, if you find 10 minutes, then you please visit a website called Amazon.com, and in this you find, just type convertibles and you will see that books being written on this word, which is convertibles. And few books I bought from Amazon, and thank you to Amazon for providing such a wonderful piece of platform. Convertibles sound the most easiest word to understand and describe. But ladies and gentlemen, I'm telling you, convertible is such a big space, and especially when it comes to hybrid convertibles. One of the most creative space in the world. I said one of the most creative space in the world of convertibles is the hybrid convertibles. Because if a right person is appointed by that startup, then he can create a perfect hybrid convertible for you. Now, when this startup issue convertibles, it means dilution. Dilution means initially you are not raising your money, you are not giving your equity. Generally, the founders hold their equity in that relevant company. But sometimes initially you give certain percentage of your equity to that relevant fund vehicle, and sometimes you give the convertibles, and sometimes you do the both. Now, when you do convertibles, here start the game, because convertibles are of various kinds. Sometimes convertibles are KRA determined. Now, that KRA is a highly disputed word, which means, let me make things relatively easier. Convertibles are outcome-based, or shortly known as outcome-based convertibles. Now, outcome-based convertibles are those convertibles whereby the final payout, or whether dilution will happen or do not happen, it depends on the outcome. And ladies and gentlemen, the outcome is 100 types. You may have an outcome that, you know, your sales should be more than $100 billion, maybe $100 million. You may have an outcome that you should reach profitability in less than 3 years. You may have an outcome that the company should not lose the potential clients in the first 4 years. You may have an outcome that no other venture capitalist or private equity come on the board. Like I said, there are 100 type of outcomes. So you cannot make a list. You cannot generalize that what kind of outcomes you are holding. But having said that, the most important thing is, now, if the outcome breach, in this eventuality, the party, which means the funding party, maybe private equity, venture capitalist, sovereign wealth fund, alternate investment fund, or anyone, that party is completely in command to convert that convertible into your equity. And here comes the accounting, and here comes the law. Because accounting-wise, you are booking losses on Y-on-Y basis. Y-on-Y means year-on-year basis. It means your net worth is practically zero. Because you are booking losses, it means your equity may have certain component, whatever, but your reserves and surplus is negative. And when your reserves and surplus is negative, it means your net worth is negative. And suppose the reserves and surplus is 100 rupees negative, while the equity is minus is 5 rupees, which means the net worth is minus 95 rupees, which is huge. In this eventuality, ladies and gentlemen, there is a threat on the head of the company, like we assume company ABC, which is called dilution risk. Which means that the party who funded you can take a control on your company very, very easily, because your net worth is completely negative in nature. Henceforth, it is the duty of the startup when you are founding a company and when you are doing whatever business you wanted to enter. When you are issuing the convertible, you should be very, very careful. In the sense like, when you are issuing the convertible, the document which you are signing, which is practically known as indenture, that indenture should be signed very carefully. Few days ago, when I was speaking with my friend, and we had an argument that whether we can have a same indenture for a profitable company and also hold the same indenture for a loss-making startup, I was of opinion that we cannot have same. The reason behind a profitable company, when they issue convertibles, The valuation parameters completely differ because here the net worth is positive. On the contrary, when the loss-making startup issue the convertible, or maybe initially when the startup is not loss-making, they issue, then the net worth is zero even at that point of time. Henceforth, assuming that common indenture for both the companies or in both the scenarios, it is feasible or not, and I was outrightly against that idea, and finally we concluded that yes, this should be the idea. Please take a note that indenture should be signed very, very carefully. Because if you are not signing the indenture carefully, then there is a big threat on that company, and that is called the dilution risk. The problem becomes worst when the same investor is coming on the board and you are requesting the investor to fund more. It means due to the dilution risk, your equity has already been diluted. And now if the same investor is coming on the board and funding fresh money, it means more or less the equity is diluted, which means the founder is holding nothing in the hands. He is only a paper founder. I know that there is not enough material on these complicated topics on the internet. I completely agree with that. But having said that, ladies and gentlemen, one thing I wish to tell you is that as the world is moving towards a startup-driven economy, henceforth, these topics should come public and we should have a healthy debate on these topics. This is really very, very important. And hopefully, as the time would progress, I would have more videos covering the convertibles in the startup space. Thank you.